We do see a rejection of the suggestion of palliative care, and it happens for many reasons, I think. In my experience, the biggest reason is not really understanding what the natural course of the disease is going to be. So depending on the condition, malignancy, what the outcome might be, dementia, the shutting down of kidney function, that dialysis is perhaps a possibility, but it doesn't bring things back to normal. It is a little bit of a plugging up a hole in a dike that will eventually fail. So it's really, do you understand what this condition, the big problem is, what the natural course of it's going to be? And I see that that really isn't understood in a lot of the cases. There's, in a portion of cases, a sense from family members that if there's a tool in the toolbox, we got to use it. I don't care if it's a screw, I got a hammer, I have a chainsaw, we're going to try and get that screw. And that is tough because it's hard because it involves a lot of healthcare workers who do care, and we struggle when we know it's not going to work with the tool that we have. And that's really important. There are other issues inside people's hearts, inside people's brains, family members, that we may not be able to get to. There may be that another parent had died and that they felt, I wasn't really there, so now it's my mom. There's no way every stone is going to be turned over. I'm not going to drop the ball on this one. So it is important for us as care providers to try and listen, to try and understand, because there are factors and issues that we often can address to make the situation less difficult, to make it more accepting, to understand what issues may be underneath. And as a healthcare provider, we need to try and reach out, because there may be some decades-old emotional issues with family members that we're not aware of.